Obeying the Gospel, October 14th. Restoration as a Principle. Let what you heard from the beginning abide in you. If what you heard from the beginning abides in you, then you too will abide in the Son and in the Father. 1 John 2:24. The concept of restoration is of fundamental importance in both the Old and the New Testaments. We can't read the Scriptures seriously and not see that if we intend to be God's faithful people, restoration must be a work we engage in. God has never, in any age of the world, left people without any standard which must be adhered to in both belief and practice. Restoration means first being reminded of the standard and then making constant efforts to bring things back into line with it. If you have any acquaintance with basic science, or if you've ever looked at your teenager's bedroom, you're familiar with the law of entropy. Left to themselves, things descend into greater and greater disorder. This law is as true in the spiritual realm as it is in the physical. Over time, things degrade. Without constant monitoring, maintenance, and restoration, we drift away from the standard God has set. And the descent into disorder is so gradual, we often don't admit to ourselves what is happening. In our individual lives, we see the need for realignment with the Scriptures more easily. But perhaps we don't recognize it as much at the congregational level. Local assemblies of Christians must commit themselves to a restoration of the apostolic order. If not, they will descend into greater entropy with each passing year. And there is no congregation where this tendency is not present. If you're a new Christian, look for a congregation that is committed to the principle of restoration. And if you've been a Christian for some time, remind the brothers and sisters where you worship that it's dangerous to be content with their past restoration efforts, as if New Testament Christianity has been fully restored and they can put things on autopilot from now on. Look for elders who are not afraid to lead their brethren in congregational acts of repentance and restoration. And look for brethren who know they need to be warned. As the Hebrew writer said in chapter 2, verse 1, we must pay closer attention to what we have heard, lest we drift away from it. Otto Reicher was not wasting words when he said, the life of the church depends on one thing, her return to biblical principles.